Welcome to the third week of this course. Last week you have created a story by yourself, and your first steps in programming might have been a little bit tricky. So this week we start with some instructional strategies to help you better understand about learning to program. So programming for children, contrary to what you might think, is not a very new idea. It's actually a quite old idea. This is Samuel Papert, and he is one of the pioneers of programming for children. And he already brought programming to the classroom in 1967. Here you see a bunch of girls in a high school classroom in the 60s already programming. And this is the age that those kids probably retire now. So it's that long ago already that people were thinking about how to teach programming to children. And Samuel Papert was a mathematician, but after his PhD, he worked with someone that you might know actually from when you went to teacher school. This was Jean Piaget, a famous French psychologist that is mainly known for describing the four levels of development of a child. And if you don't know it exactly from your training, the first stage in development, if children are between 0 and 2 years old, is the sensory motor stage. And at this stage, you know this, babies, they don't really have a conception of what happens in the world. They just grab things and try to experience the world with their senses. After this, you have the pre-operational stage. And in the pre-operational stage, children start to develop hypotheses. They say things like, oh, maybe it's raining because the sky is sad. It's not a very good hypothesis, but they're trying to understand why things around them are happening. After that, if children are between 7 and 11, the concrete operational stage starts. And this is where children can really reason about things. However, they can only reason about concrete things, so things that are in front of them. But it's very hard still to reason about abstract things. That only happens if children are above the age of 11, so generally when they are after elementary school. And a theory that has really helped me understand programming and understand learning to program is neo-Piagetism. And neo-Piagetism is the same as Piagetism. The only difference is, as you see here, the ages are removed. So the theory of neo-Piagetism says that when you start to learn a new skill, you fall back to the lowest level. So even if you're already an adult and you're very much capable of doing formal operational reasoning about language or mathematics, if you learn programming, you go back to the lowest level. And this even applies to the students that we have here at TU Delft. University level students even reason at the sensory motor stage. They look at a piece of code and they just have no conception. They're not aware of developing any hypothesis because they just have no context. And I think the best comparison between learning to program is learning a new language, a real natural language. So for example, this is a sentence in Greek. If you don't know Greek, I don't really know Greek, I can't really reason about this sentence. The only thing I can do is I read this letter by letter. So, this is an alpha, and then you have a gamma, and then a pi. I cannot do it at once. It takes me a lot of time, and after a while, I can read words, and then I can read sentences, and it really takes some practice to write a complicated piece in Greek yourself. And that's really how programming is too. And teachers of programming, especially teachers that are programmers themselves, often want to teach children about logical reasoning as soon as possible, because logical reasoning is so important for programming. Well, of course, it's true, it is important for programming. It's also important for language, by the way. But you can only write a logically coherent piece if you don't have to spend any energy, any brain cycle on spelling and grammar. You really can't write an essay if you have to look up every word or every letter in Greek. And this is also the case with programming. And next week we will help you understand how to reach a new level in the neo-Piagetan stages. But for now, it will just help you to understand that don't worry, it just takes a while. You'll be in those low stages for a while. And afterwards, you will be able to do logical reasoning in programming.